You have seen we have entered all the transactions. Now the next step is to close down the cash book. Now first, as you remember, we have to close the discount column. The rule for closing the discount column is we have to just total them and leave it, no balancing for discount column. So on debit side we have discount allowed total 700. Now moving on to the credit side, we have discount received, so it is 600. Now that's how we close our discount columns. Now we have to balance the cash and bank column. So let us first balance cash column. So before entering the greater total on both the sides, I am totaling the debit side. The debit side total comes to 32,300. Now check what is the total on the credit side. Here the total is 6,000. Now since 32,300 is more, we enter 32,300 on both the sides. What it means? It means you have put you have received money worth 32,300, out of which you paid money 6,000. So when you take the difference, 32,300 minus 6,000, it is 26,300. This is the cash available with you at the end of the month. So 31st December is the date. It is the closing balance. So buy is constant on credit, balance, because closing we will use the word carried down, that is with your cash. In the same fashion we are going to close our bank column. First check what are the totals on both the sides. On debit side our total is 21,500. If you see the credit side, the total comes to 15,600. In this case also the debit side total is more. You are entering 21,500 on both the sides in the total. Now from 21,500 remove this 15,600, you will be getting 5,900. So this is your total on in cash book for the bank column and the balancing figure. So we have to reopen this for next month. So give the date, after December comes Jan. So it is 2013 the year, 1st Jan. 2 is constant on the debit because opening balance, hence balance brought down because we are opening the account. So cash is 26,300 and bank 5,900. So that comes to end of the problem number 8.